Right. So in this lecture, let's talk about mobile gestures. Okay. So let me create one more class. New class. Let's say gestures. Okay. So let's go back to our Android emulator. Right. So here, when we open the app, let's start from the beginning. Click on views. Thereafter, I need to click on expandable lists. Thereafter, custom adapter. Okay. So after coming to this page, I want to press and hold these people names. So when I do that, I would get one pop-up saying sample menu, sample action. So I want to get the text of this sample menu. So that's my test case. So what the scenario was different from the previous lectures. So the only difference we have here is, till now, in the last lectures, we have seen how to click and, you know, how to send the keys. But we did not try something like pressing and holding that till something pop-up comes up. Okay, and we did not deal with pop-ups as well. So let's see how can we do that. It's basically a long press. So if you are aware of using Android, if you want to know about more about that specific option, if you long press on it or press and hold on it for some time, then the pop-up opens. So now we need to see how can we automate that long press scenario. Okay, so as usual, let's start with desired capabilities. But as I told in my previous lecture, I have declared all my desired capabilities in the base section. So I would just call this here, probably class gestures extends base, so that all the base properties, I can access it here, just like how we have done in the previous basics. Okay, let me copy these two sentences again. So it's like all the capabilities. Okay, move your mouse and add the rows declaration. So all your capabilities it has set here, and it is returning the driver. Okay, so the driver which we have written here, you can remove this because this is duplicate. I already defined it here, right? So we need not give again the implicit weight. Okay, right. So first, I need to click on views. Okay, so it invokes the app for me. I think we already done a test of handling views in our previous lecture. Let me take out that from there. Oh, we have not done. That's fine. So okay, so let me open my UI Automator viewer to get the object of this views. You can open it by just, you know, clicking on UI Automator Viewer in the SDK tools bin folder. It was located here. Okay, so let me take the screenshot. Right, views, we have the text. Let's do an XPath. Driver dot find element with XPath slash slash. Here comes our tag name. Array text attribute equals to views. Okay, so perfect. It clicks on the text attribute. And now, let me introduce one mobile gesture, that is tap. Okay, so do you know, we generally tap on our mobile apps. So there is a lot of difference between click and tap. Okay, if you want to tap on it, if you just touch it, automatically, generally we say tap on it. If you touch that object, it opens another page or the action will be performed. So the click, in the sense, you need to deliberately press or hold on it, okay? Whereas tap is just, you can touch your hand on that object so that action will be performed. That's how we generally do in mobile, okay? There might be some specific test cases, okay? So in the last year when I have done mobile project, I was asked the scenarios like, verify these actions are performed by being tapping on it. You should not click on it. So if you want to open the menu, open the menu here, so let's say I need to click on drag and drop. I'll just tap on it, that's it. It should perform the action, okay? So how to tap on mobile apps? Let's start with that first gesture, okay? So to work on mobile gestures, the Appium guys has designed a class called Touch Actions. So let me write the touch actions. So move your mouse and it asks you to import touch actions. And here you need to pass your driver as an argument. Okay. So whenever you pass your driver argument into this touch actions class, so that this T variable, which is an object of this class, has the capabilities of handling mobile gestures. Okay, this is an, now T knows about the driver and as well as the mobile capabilities. So that's the power of T variable here.